I'm Eric Wielander, and it's so nice to see you back here for another video. Today, we're going to learn about how to use the new prototyping feature in Sketch version 49. Personally, I'm not a designer. I'm an app developer, but that doesn't mean that I don't need to use tools like Sketch. Even if it's just for getting files from designers and slicing them up into things I put into an app, Sketch is a very powerful tool, not only for that, but also for me to be able to create some ideas really quickly that's faster to just draw up in Sketch than it would be to write in code, and then try those ideas out and see what works. And that's really where this prototyping feature can help take that process to the next level, because you don't even have to send the mock-up out into any other app. You can just do that right in Sketch and make tappable prototypes that you can share right from inside the app. Okay, so we're here in Sketch and we have a new project open that's completely blank. And so these transitions really happen between different artboards. So we need to go ahead and create an artboard first. So go down here and create an artboard, and we're gonna just choose a traditional iPhone 10 size. And now one of the great things about Sketch is that they have the iOS, some iOS reference libraries built right in. So you can go ahead and add things like, let's just add a navigation bar. So we'll just put that up here at the top. Looking pretty good. I'm gonna override the title to say, welcome. So this is like the first screen of the app. I don't know why you'd ever want to say welcome. This is why I'm a developer and not a designer. Then if you go ahead and type some text here, say next screen. Okay, and then we're gonna make this like that big. Okay, I don't want it to be bold. So I'm just gonna make it medium, and we'll make it SF display. I already have that installed on this. That's Apple's font so that it looks like the rest of the screen. Okay, I don't know why it's gray. Let's make it black. We have this next screen button and we want it to take us to the next screen. So let's go ahead and make that next screen. So we need to go here to artboard, and then we'll choose iPhone 10 again. So we have a new iPhone 10 artboard, and we can call this, let's give our artboards a name so we're organized here. So we'll name that first screen, and then we'll go up here and name the next one next screen. So then from there, let me just do some things that make it look different. I don't know, maybe another navigation bar, but then we'll have it say something different. So let's add this one with a search. I can go here and customize that. So next screen. There we go. So now I'm gonna link this next screen button over to this screen. So all I have to do is, there's a few different ways you can do this, but I'm just gonna go ahead and hit the link button up in the toolbar, and then I can just drag it over and select this other screen. And you can choose over here in the prototyping menu which screen you want it to go to. And you can also choose the style of animation. So, you know, a cover left or whatever is the navigation controller traditional thing. So I'm gonna do that. Let's also, just for detail, let's make this back button say back. That's good. Okay, so now we have a simple little prototype, and we can hit preview here. And we're actually on the next screen because we have that selected. But if we're over here on the first screen in this little drop-down menu and we tap this button, it takes us to the next screen. So, but right now, nothing happens if we want to go back. So then from here, another way that we can add a tappable area rather than just linking an element is doing a hotspot. So I'm going to go over here to the new menu and choose hotspot. And then I can choose to make a hotspot here. I'm gonna choose to do that there. And now I'm gonna go ahead and just go over here in the inspector and choose that I want it to go to the first screen. So that will take it back, and I want the transition to be the reverse, the one going over, so that it looks nice. And then if we go back here to preview, And we hit back, we're taken back to the main screen. So that looks all good. You can also share these prototypes on the cloud, and you can also share them on the Sketch Mirror app on your iPhone or iPad. So you can actually touch the prototype on a phone and see what it looks like. But the other interesting thing to point out is, let's say for working purposes, for whatever reason, I wanted to be working with this with a red background. But what I can do is I can choose whether I want it to, like anything else in Sketch, include that color in the export. And if I uncheck that box, it also removes that from the prototype. So if I go here to preview and I'm on next screen, if you notice, the prototype of next screen is white, but the modified background color in the artboard is red. And that's because we didn't choose to export that. So if I go ahead and check that box, then I go back to preview, you'll notice now the prototype is red. So a whole lot of great things you can do with prototypes, but the hot spots and the linking are probably two of the best features to get you started. And it's really easy to either do it from a new project like this or to go into an existing Sketch project and start to add these navigation flows through it and trying some stuff out. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up if you did. Leave a comment below if you have any personal experience with the new prototyping built into Sketch, what you think of it. I'd love to hear any tips or tricks you really like to use with this new version of Sketch. Subscribe if you're not already. Thanks again so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.